the only way for us to truly have local food systems that involve meat is for the meat to find an avenue from the farm to the home. That's what butchers do. They get the meat from the slaughterhouse, they store it, they know how to cut it up. They're really like the fulcrum of a local food system.
Hey, how you doing? I'm Ryan Farr. Welcome to 4505 Meats Butcher Shop. Up until about 4 years ago when we started this company, was running restaurants and left that to go work for a nonprofit. Really had a hard time paying the bills. Had a baby on the way. I had some pig skins in my fridge, so I started making the chicharrones and started selling them to bars. And this is our first actual brick and mortar. Just get meat to the people of San Francisco.
My name is Aaron, and I co-own the local butcher shop with my wife, Monica. We've had opposite schedules since we've known each other.
So we wanted to do something that we could see each other more regularly, and also something that we could have a more direct impact on our community. While meat was an important factor in opening a butcher shop, the primary driver was being able to spend more time together.
My name's Angela Wilson. I co-own Avedano's Holly Park Market here in Bernal Heights. This has been a butcher shop since 1901, and that's all it's ever been. And really, we didn't have any idea what we were doing. I like to think that, like, because we didn't, we weren't thinking of bottom lines and profits and losses and stuff, and we just kind of did what we felt was right, which was trying to do as many whole animals from small farms around the area that we could.
I think taking the art form of butchery and the craft of butchery and exposing people to that is really important, because people don't make the connection that the packages of meat that they get at the supermarket actually come from an animal.
It's a set of skills that's probably more diverse than you would imagine. And besides having to know the anatomy of an animal and where to cut it, you have to know how to cook, because cutting up an animal is a means to an end. So you have to understand where all those things are gonna end up.
So people come in, you know, we're right here, we're 3 feet apart from each other. You can tell they're trying to like figure out what they want. So first question is, what are you looking for? What are you looking to cook? What do you want to eat? And then we start there. Somebody's like, oh, I want to have a steak. I want a big steak, baked potato dinner. I'm saying, oh, look at this ribeye. It's pretty slamming right now.
They can ask us questions on how to cook things, like the more obscure things that we have.
Well, I think a butcher can create a sense of neighborhood. When the local butcher shop opened, it made me start shopping more locally, because I would go in there and it was just such a nice feeling to get my dinner and they know who I was.
Seeing the same people over and over, they become your friend.
You know, we've only been open for a year and 3 months, but we've already seen, you know, a whole generation that's starting to have a butcher shop as part of their experience of growing up.
We're selling you, you know, trust. This is exactly what I feed my family, and this, if you go home and cook this, how we're telling you, or how you prefer to cook it, this is gonna be the best tasting piece of meat you've had.
For me, it's really relaxing, almost like a meditation or something. You know, I mean, you go through step one through 20 all the same way every time, so it's kind of like doing like a martial art form. The more you do it, the more natural it is to you. It just kind of puts your mind at ease and it's relaxing.
There's just so many different ways that you can cut an animal, and different cultures have different ways. I love just kind of, you know, geeking out and making nice clean cuts, and especially like making a case. It's like mowing the lawn. You know, it's a bitch when you're doing it, it's hot and you're mowing it, but then when like it's all done and you can like smell that grass and look at it, it's like, oh, this is pretty nice looking. I just like to cut shit, man. You know? No, it's fun. I couldn't imagine doing anything else. It makes people happy. You know, I love talking to people, I love educating people, and I, you know, love to hear back what they say, because that's the only way I'm learning. Every time I teach something, it seems like I'm always learning something too.
So we buy all whole animals from local ranchers from within 150 miles from here.
You know, when you're getting the whole animal, you really need to have a use for everything. And so when you're buying a whole beef or a whole pig or just a whole rabbit or a whole chicken, you know, you want to be able to use everything. You don't want to throw anything away. this is a whole animal right here. You know, we got all the steaks here, all the chops, and then we got all the non-steaks and chops over here that we turn into sausage. And then we use everything.
Stocks, soups,
dog food, dog chews.
One type of sandwich that changes daily.
Nothing goes to waste.
That way, you know, the small farmer can stay in business and have somewhere to place all the stuff that everybody, like in a supermarket, doesn't want to buy.
It's not just about using everything, but using it in a really respectful way, using it in the most delicious way, and just having a direct pipeline from the farm to the table.
You know, and for these farmers, the life isn't easy. I mean, it's not giant profits. Just seeing that people are, you know, changing the directions of their life, just trying to live a more simple life and find value in producing a really good product in an honest way.
Most people who are small farmers are putting a lot of love into each animal, and the animals usually are moving around more, they're eating a more diverse diet, they have a longer life.
And this is just a beautiful grass-fed beef. In here, there's just some really nice intermuscular fat and marbling. This translates to flavor and juiciness and tenderness. Comes from our buddy Lauren Poncho up in Stemple Creek, right along the coast. He says some of the salts from the air, from the sea, kind of build up on the grass and it adds to the flavor. So when you're cooking this, you can get a little hint of the ocean sometimes in the flavor of the meat. So this is, you know, something special.
You know, you can eat a lot of the fat, a lot of the beef fat, a lot of the pig fat. You know, it's good for you. You know, it hasn't been injected or given hormones or fed a poor diet. You know, you want to eat something that's happy animal.
I think having a butcher shop in each community, in every community, is really important for people to have access to good quality meat.
And for me, I mean, this is not, you know, I'm not gonna strike it rich. This is a lifestyle, and in the end, for me, it's been such a pleasure to be an employer to people who, this is their life passion, people who really wanna do this job, and young kids, and, you know, passing on what I've learned to people, that's one of the best rewards of it.
I think it just gives people a sense of place that's really nice and simple and sweet.